Today I'm looking at the Canon EOS M100 mirrorless camera. The EOS M100 pretty much retains almost the same design as the original EOS M, which I reviewed several years ago. It has a solid metal body with a chunky lens on the front, and like the original M, it doesn't have a deep grip. However, the camera is still pretty compact and comfortable to hold when compared to a DSLR. Here I have it next to my Panasonic G7, which is about the size of a very compact DSLR. I also like this textured surface on the front, which definitely improves the grip. However, it isn't as compact as its biggest competitor, the Sony A5100. And throughout this review, I'll be comparing it to the A5100. Now, quite a bit has changed since the original EOS M, and even since the newer EOS M10, which I tested last year. For starters, the EOS M100 has a brand new 24 megapixel APS-C size sensor behind its stock 15 to 45 millimeter lens. This is the same sensor you'd find on a DSLR like a Canon T6i, T7i, or the newer SL2. Since this camera uses Canon's newer EF-M lens mount, you can use some of the EF-M lenses available for it, and I'll leave links to some options below. However, if you already own Canon lenses, you can use Canon EF series lenses with an adapter like this one, and I'll leave a link to that adapter below as well. The button layout on the top of the camera is almost unchanged from the EOS M10, with a mode dial surrounding a power button, its shutter button, and the movie record button all the way to the right. It also comes with a pop-up flash built into the left-hand corner of the top face. The buttons on the rear face are the standard set of buttons you'd expect to find on any camera. Like the EOS M10, its 3-inch screen flips up all the way for selfies and vlogs. More about the vlog video quality in a minute. The screen is a really nice display, which is very crisp, has fantastic viewing angles, and works really well even outdoors in the bright sunlight. And it's much better than the display on the Sony A5100. It's also a touchscreen, and the menus and options on the camera are laid out in typical Canon fashion, simple, clean, and easy to navigate. Another thing I like about the EOS M100 is the placement of the SD card slot. Unlike some other DSLRs and mirrorless cameras, the SD card slot is very conveniently located on the compartment on the left-hand edge, instead of with the battery on the bottom. So you don't even need to take the camera off a tripod to pull out the SD card. The micro HDMI port to connect it to TVs and monitors, and the mini USB port to connect and charge the camera live in this compartment next to the SD card. And talking about charging, the M100 thankfully comes with a standalone wall charger, so you can pop your battery out of the compartment on the bottom and charge it. This also allows you to buy spare batteries so you can keep using your camera while your depleted batteries charge. I'll leave links to spare batteries below in case you're looking to buy some. When it comes to pictures, it can shoot images as large as 24 megapixels and stores them in either the JPEG format, RAW, or as both a JPEG file and RAW file for each picture. As expected, the image quality was absolutely amazing. The most impressive thing about this camera, as with most Canons, was its color reproduction and the overall aesthetic of the pictures. The pictures had a very pleasant aesthetic to them. The colors seemed very accurately reproduced, and like a DSLR, it had a nice shallow depth of field with smooth bokeh. Now, focus speed has never been a strong suite of the Canon EOS M lineup. However, the Canon EOS M100 has improved quite a bit from the EOS M10 and is years ahead of the original EOS M. When I compared it to the Sony A5100, it focused almost as quickly as the A5100. The pictures from the M100 had a much more pleasant aesthetic to them, though, when it came to color. However, the A5100 had slightly sharper images, as you can see here. The EOS M100 also seems to expose the images more accurately than the Sony. The Canon definitely produces better looking pictures overall. The EOS M100's low light performance was also exceptionally impressive, as you can see from these shots. The pictures were very well exposed, sharp, and had very little noise even with the flash turned off. While it still doesn't shoot 4K, it can shoot 1080p at 60 FPS for slow motion video. It can also shoot 1080p at 30 and 24 FPS if you needed to. When I tested it in the 1080p at 60 FPS mode, I found that like the pictures it takes, the color reproduction and overall aesthetic was gorgeous. However, like most Canons, the video was a bit soft and lacked the crispness you'd get from a camera like the Panasonic G7, G85, or GH4. That still doesn't make it a bad camera for video. With a bit of color correction, you can get nice super slow-mo video like this. The 1080p video at 20fps is also decent. However, like the 60fps video, it's definitely not the sharpest video out there. So you're probably wondering, how does this camera perform as a vlogging camera? So the video you're seeing right now is directly from the Canon EOS M100, and the audio that's being recorded is also being recorded directly into the EOS M100. And as you can probably tell, the recording quality is pretty good, especially since it is recording in the 60fps mode, which gives you this super smooth video. So the built-in microphone quality is actually pretty important, especially since this doesn't have a 3.5mm headphone jack, and thus you can't add an external microphone. And from what I can see, based on my tests, the quality seems to be pretty good. So should you buy the Canon EOS M100? Well, despite the fact that it still doesn't shoot 4K video, the EOS M100 is a very useful camera. It shoots amazing still images and very pleasing 1080p video at 60fps for that slow motion video. And to top that, it's very nicely built, simple, intuitive, and convenient to use. If you're looking for a compact camera that shoots pictures and video as good as a DSLR, the Canon EOS M100 is a perfect choice. The Sony A5100 is still a bit cheaper than the Canon and is also a very good camera, but if you can afford to spend the extra money, I definitely recommend going for the M100. I'll leave links to both cameras below in case you're looking to buy one. Hope this video was useful. If it was, please hit that like button and subscribe for more reviews, unboxings, and how-to videos. If you own one of these cameras, tell me about your experience in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.